So we're looking at another chart really similar to the previous example, given a group test group of students. And this is going to summarize the grade earned by gender. Now, if one student is chosen at random, find the probability that student earned a B given the student is female. So right away, given the student is female, we're only looking at this row right here. Now, favorable outcomes, the student earned a B. So favorable is 13. Total is not 56, because that would include the male students. The total students here are 26. So this is just 13 out of 26. And that does reduce to 1/2, or 0.5 as a decimal. Now the next question is going to be similar but a little different. Now, if one student is chosen at random, find the probability the student is not a female and did not earn a C. So unlike the one before, there was no given information. So it doesn't say we're only considering C students or only considering females. So not a female and did not earn a grade C. So what I'm going to do in red is I'm going to circle everything that is not favorable. So here's all the C's, and I'm skipping the totals here. So these are not favorable and not female. So it really narrows it down. Originally there was six outcomes, and we've gotten rid of four of the six. So not female and did not earn a C, which means they're male and either A or a B. So we can just compute this directly. 19 over 69 plus 3 over 69. You can also add those together, 22 over 69. So that is one way to compute it. Probably, in my opinion, one of the most straightforward ways to compute it. You don't really want to use these totals, because if you would use that total and any of these totals, you would have double counted some of the male students, because they'd be added in both of these totals here. So you want to be very careful. I like to just think about the whole chart and compute everything right there.